Hello, this video session is about introduction to AJAX. AJAX is an acronym for asynchronous JavaScript and XML. AJAX basically provides an ability to communicate with the server asynchronously. It means it is basically a client-side technology that combines other technologies that makes us to retrieve the data from the server very quickly and in a user-friendly manner. So AJAX is a client-side technique that combines a set of technologies in order to create faster and more user-friendly web pages. AJAX is based on JavaScript, and the main functionality is to access the web server's data response that is to be displayed on the client-side's JavaScript codes. AJAX is not a programming language. It is a methodology which acts on several web technologies. So let us try to understand in this small diagram here, which provides us the details about the client and the server. So a client gets some responses from the server. That is, a client requests some information. For suppose here in this example, the client is trying to get information about the index.php. So when the client sends the request, the index.php request is being passed on from the client to the server, and the server responds to that if the index.php is available on that web server. So when the response comes, the response will be in this particular form, is basically the hypertext transfer protocol, followed by the version number and the status code. Status code 200 indicates that index.php is available on the server, and the content type is basically the HTML contents that is coming from the server, and this is the HTML content that is to be given onto your that as a response onto the client. So once this particular response has been received onto the client, now the client machine tries to interact with the user, and with respect to different user requests that are coming interactively onto this particular web page, the index.php, there may be several requests comes. For example, here the user may is trying to interact with another page which may tries to get some more information based on his request. Suppose from the client machine through the index.php, if the user navigates to another page or another request that has been originated from this index.php, again the request goes to the server. Now the request that is going to the server is basically an asynchronous request. This means short, we call it as AJAX request. So the AJAX request goes to this web server, and again the AJAX tries to retrieve the data from the server. It means it is grabbing the data from the server, and is, as a response that is going to be given to the user when the user interacts with several other web pages which are linked to this index.php. So if you look to this this AJAX mechanism, it happens in the background, and the server always, if that is a request is been available, then the server responds to that, and the user interactions will be very friendly and in a speedy manner. At the same time, the web pages need not be reloaded in the sense that all the time whenever a new request comes from this user, the web page need not be sent all the contents again to the server and get the responses accordingly. So here only the requests that have been made by the user in interacting with the web page, only those requests are been sent through this AJAX request, and the response also comes in the form of AJAX responses with respect to those web contents that needs to be displayed or to be interacted by the user. So in order to have this AJAX operations or the AJAX functionality between the client and the server, which happens in the background and which need not reload the web pages again and again during the web interactions, this AJAX functionality can be understood with the help of an object. That object is basically called as XML HTTP request object. So this XML HTTP request object is to be created with the help of your XML HTTP request method. So, you know, this basically an object concepts here. And this XML HTTP object tries to perform a sequence of operations or the sequence of functionalities, such as first it opens up a connection to the server. It's trying to get the information from the server by specifying the URL, what exactly the URL, the page which the user is trying to request, or the page which the user is trying to acquire or gather, or basically grab the information from the server with the help of method function. The method function here is the open method. So the syntax for this open method is to have get or a post method followed by the URL, that's a destination resource location which is available on the web server, followed by a true or false, a boolean value, which represents whether it is asynchronous or not. Then similarly, you have another method called as the send method, which that particular method tries to send the data from your client to the server. So once the response has come from the server, that response can be made visible or made can be made accessible to the user if the JavaScript functionality, such as using the DOM concepts, you can make the availability of the responses on the DOM objects. So you can display the responses in any of those contents of the DOM objects using the document.getElementById followed by the division ID, the content, and you can place your corresponding responses that are coming from the server. So here the need for an AJAX is that whenever you have some dynamic nature on the web pages and the users are interacting it dynamically, so AJAX helps the users to fetch the data from the server in an asynchronous manner, which is happening at the background when you write the JavaScript function for the AJAX. Interaction with the users becomes slower as functionality increases. It is obvious that the more functions that you keep it on a web page makes those interactions more in number, and it may lead to more latencies, in the sense that the responses coming from the web server are very poor. So when the speed has to be increased, then the AJAX is going to take care of that one. So the AJAX functionality is very much needed to increase the speed, that is to decrease the latency, the delays which are happening in getting the responses from the web server. One well-known example is the Google suggestions, that you get it on the Google search bar or on the Google's searching mechanism, which you give on a word, similar words or the other set of words that are matching to the entered word is going to be given here. Basically, Google is using the AJAX mechanism. So that is, the AJAX functionality has been taken care to give the responses that are coming from the server onto the client machines. Please do remember, the AJAX responses, we can easily handle them with the help of this DOM objects. So whenever you get the responses from the AJAX, these DOM objects will help us to hold that particular responses and display or make the manipulations or make interactivity with the user very effectively. So if you see the DOM structure, the DOM is nothing but your web document. That web document document will have the root element, that is what your HTML. The HTML section has got several other sections, which includes the head section and the body section. So inside the body section, you have several other sections too, which depends, means basically it is a hierarchy, which you might have seen in the previous videos. So what are the responses that you get it from the server? It can be easily been stored or it can be held by your respective DOM objects. Now let us see some of the syntax and the corresponding methods and the properties that are to be understood by this AJAX functionalities. So one of the important methods for your AJAX is the XML HTTP request object. So this XML HTTP request object, one of the method that is going to be used is the open method. So this method, open method, has got three different parameters. The get or a post method can be given, followed by the URL or the destination of the resource objects that you are trying to access or to retrieve the data, and followed by the, if you are going for a asynchronous or a synchronous operations that needs to be performed on the web pages. And here, whenever you get the responses from the server, you may have these responses in terms of the properties. So this can be understood like this. It is a ready state, which indicates that the user is trying to identify the status of that particular request that is made from the client. So it's basically from 0 to 4. On ready state, yes, ready to have that particular events that have been handled by the web client side, that is on the user trying to request for different operations. And the statuses such as 200, which indicates that the web the web resource is available based on the request that the user has made, or whether the web pages are not available or it's not available on that server, or so on and so forth. You can get the responses, 5 different status scores that we have seen in the previous videos. So these are the important properties and the methods that you need to understand here. So one important, some of the benefits of using the Ajax is to, basically Ajax helps us to build up a dynamic websites, basically in the sense that user interactivity will be very easy, faster, and based on the user request, the website gives the corresponding responses. So Ajax allows us to perform processing on client machine with the data taken from the server, thereby reducing the server load by moving a part of the server functionality on the client side itself. So the Ajax will take care of only the requested parts of those things which have been interacted by the user very effectively. The advantage of the Ajax is that it saves the bandwidth by only transmitting the new information which the user is trying to retrieve from the web server. No need to reload the web pages, no need to send all the contents of the web page, and you get back the responses. So a lot of data need not be transmitting between the client and the server most of the time. Ajax also has some disadvantages here. Ajax has got some limited capabilities in handling the old web browsers. So whenever your Ajax functionality is to be run on an old web browser, you need to take care of the appropriate method. So the XML HTTP request is not the method that needs to be considered here. So we'll see it in an example, what is the other method to be used for the old browsers and for other mobile devices. Sometimes some multimedia data like your images or videos or audio, which you are trying to interact with your webcams or the output devices. So there may be some kind of a delay is going to happen, which may not be in a real time, the operations may not perform. So that may makes us to have some kind of delays and the responses gets very slow. So too much code makes the browser slow. If suppose more Ajax functions are being kept on the same web page, then obviously the responses also will be very slow. And please make sure that your JavaScript is enabled. JavaScript is being supported by your browser to run the various Ajax functions. Now let us see a small demo on how Ajax is functioning. So here, let us go to our WAMP server. So on the WAMP server, on the back, so I'm just starting the localhost server. Right, then let me open the phpMyAdmin. So here, in continuation of the previous videos, here we have a database called MySite2. So under the MySite2, you can create a table. So the table is, the name of the table is here, students. And I have created some records. You know how to insert the data into this table. So the records are something like ID, student ID, student first name, student last name, age, hometown, degree. There are some of the fields, other some of the columns, or you can call it as an attributes. So you have inserted some sample data here. So this record one is basically the first name is A, last name ZZ, age 26, hometown Hyderabad, MTech. Degree student, something like this. You can create some dummy data over here on this database MySite2 in the with the students table. So once your data is available on your database, now let us write the scripts. So here, so this script is basically your HTML script, which includes your Java script also. So here, these are the HTML tags. So this is basically your JavaScript from here to here. So I'll get back to this explanation very short. So if you see the form object, the form element has got a selection tag, which gives us the options of 1, 2, 3, 4, where the user is trying to select one of the option here. So once the user selects a particular option, then what is that data which related to that particular option that is to be displayed here under the division ID text hint. So this ID name I have given here as a text hint. So the selection tag has got an attribute on change whenever a user changes one an option here. So the this we on change, we have written a function, JavaScript function, show user, by passing this dot value, the corresponding value, whatever the user has selected from here, the value is passed on to the show user function. So the show user function is this. You know how to write means you can define a JavaScript function here, function followed by the name of the function, and the argument of this function is a str which the user selects. So user is selecting one of the option, so str contains the option value selected by the user. If the user does not select any value, you need to just simply return that particular value. Else, if the user has got some value, str has got a value the user has selected, so then we need to come to this particular part here. So what is that here doing here is basically you are creating an XML HTTP object. This object name need not be the same. You can give any appropriate name here, but that object should be of type XML HTTP request. That's what the requirement. So all the latest browsers, IE7 plus Firefox, Chrome, Opera, Safari, you can use this particular function called XML HTTP request, which creates an object XML HTTP. For older browsers, please make sure that this XML HTTP is of ActiveX objects. And that particular ActiveX object is of XML HTTP function, which is coming from the Microsoft. We basically, for old browsers such as Internet Explorer 6 and 5, can run on this particular ActiveX objects method. But all the latest browsers, you can make use of this XML HTTP request. And once you create this object, now this object, you are going to invoke a method called open. That's what the syntax. So in the slides I have given, so that open method has got three different parameters, the get method followed by the URL. So here the URL is get user details.php, and that particular get user.php has got an input, that is the Q value, which comes from the this str value. And you are making the third parameter to be true, which indicates that you need to run this function asynchronously. So this particular str value is being passed on from this particular page, that is ajax.x.html, to an another destination page, that is getusersdetails.php, which is available on the server. So that value has been passed on as an argument. You can see this a variable Q is whatever the value that user has given here, that value has been carried forward from this ajax.ex.html to another page called getusers.php. So in this particular HTML page, you have written a JavaScript function, which is basically to create an XML HTTP object. And that XML HTTP object is trying to connect, make an open connection with this particular getusers.php. And you're trying to send this particular object to retrieve that particular values from the server. So once you get the response from the server, that is, you need to specify it like this, XML HTTP on ready state. So on ready state, once the there is a ready, the client side is ready to receive the values which are coming from the server with the status 200. It means the web, that requested web resource, that is getusersdetails.php, is available, and the status says that yes, it is okay to retrieve these particular pages. Those values have been hold, or those values have been displayed onto your document object model, that is your text hint. So the text hint is here at the bottom of the screen. So the text hint is this particular division. So whatever the responses that comes from the server are going to be displayed here. So the let me just show you the intermediate part of this one right now. So let me see how this goes on here. So that is my site 2, followed by Ajax HTML. So here, this is what your front end, that's what ajax.ex.html page looks like. This is a select box. So here on the select box, you have the different options here. So the user, once they select here, the response should come here. So this is what the front end. So here, when I click one, so you are getting the data from your database. So whenever there is a change on the select box, so that corresponding data has been retrieved here. So the data is coming in the form of an asynchronous object. That is what XML HTTP request object is trying to make use of this. If you remember, I have not given the data for 3, so it is empty here. So now what is the, how to retrieve the data? That is the process that is happening on the server. The code for the server is basically your get users details.php. So that get user details.php is nothing but the first statement will be your PHP tag followed by you are using the $_get global reference variable, the PHP global reference variable, the queue which has been forwarded from this particular. This is what your get user details.php, the queue value which is coming from your this particular page, that is your .html page onto this particular page, PHP. Once you get that value, store it in your local variable. So $q is your local variable in this PHP script file. So this particular, I am displaying whatever the variables for you to have a quick reference here. And the remaining steps, basically this is the MySQL connect to your localhost database server. The user of that particular database is a root. I have not given any password as of now. And the database name is MySite. So once the connection is established, so you are going to give an SQL statement, select star from students where ID is equal to whatever the local variable Q value that has been selected from the user, which is coming from a .html page, that particular value you are giving to this SQL statement, and you are running that particular SQL statement with the function MySQLi query. So MySQLi underscore connect is basically an API method that connects to your database. And MySQL underscore query is a method that is running by making a connection establishment with the database and performing the query $SQL. And the results are going to be held by your local variable dot $result. And you are going to display a table structure that you can use it to your echo statement. That what you have seen on the print page here, this is what the header, first name, last name, age, hometown. So this is basically your table which is displayed here under this particular section. So now that, let me just complete this code. So here, while you are trying to fetch each row based on, obviously in this case, you are fetching only a particular row. So based on the ID value that is entered from the user on the front page. So you are fetching the first name, last name, age, town, and the degree. So once the data is been fetched, all the records have been fetched. Obviously it is, in this case is one record. Then you try to close your connection pointer, otherwise it will be a dangling reference. So this is how you just simply write a particular PHP MySQL page to retrieve the data, and this response is given onto this particular web page. So XML HTTP responses are going to be stored or are going to be held by this particular section ext text hints, which is an inner part of that you are going to store in this division, and that data has been displayed. Your person information will be listed here. So if you see the once again, I just run this, see the person information will be listed here. At present it is empty, nothing is here. So once the user selects an option, that particular section is going to display what are the data that is retrieved from the database. Yeah, so the reference for this particular AJAX session what I have taken is from this particular source. So the source can be easily downloadable, the book can be downloadable. You can click to this particular, go to the link, AJAX creating web pages with asynchronous JavaScript and XML. So the steps are given here. Those that book is basically an open source book. So the steps, you can see several examples here. So this is an AJAX. The book is basically an open source series book. You can download and make use of this reading and try to understand and proceed with different examples here. Yeah. Thank you.